how to use VirtualDub to capture an analog source, for example a VHS tape from a recorder. I show you the basics. I assume that you have installed VirtualDub and a PCI-TV card or an USB video capture device. The best way to get a good quality out of an analog source is to use the S-video output and to use the same recorder which recorded the movie, to playback it if possible. By using S-video, color and chroma informations are transferred over two separate wires. You can also use the composite output, but the quality is not as good as the S-video output. Here you can see the back of two Panasonic NVFS200 Super-VHS recorder. The lower device has a SCART adapter plugged in, to show how to get a composite output. Underneath the SCART adapter, you can see the S-video in and output. Beside it you can see the audio output. First you have to open VirtualDub, and start the capture mode. Then you have to set a capture file. Choose a path and a file name. After that, you have to select your device. At this point I can see the video stream, but you cannot, because the tool I use cannot record the content of the capturing screen of VirtualDub. Then go to the video menu and select the correct video source. In my case it is the S video source. Now select the correct video standard. Because I live in Europa I choose PAL B. After that you have to choose which compression you want to use. In my case I want to use a lossless compression. Therefore you can choose between a handful of codecs. For this example I will use Lagarith lossless codec. These codecs are not pre-installed on your computer, so you have to download them from the internet and install it before you can use it. If you press the configuration button you can configure in which color space the video will be recorded. This can be important if you want to encode this video later with Avasynth. Also set the custom video format you want to have. To finalize the video configuration, you have to set how much frames you want to capture each second. Last but not least, select the sound quality. If you have done all these steps, you can now start the capturing process. On the right side you can see a lot of informations about the capturing process. At this point, I will stop the capturing process, because my demonstration has finished now. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked it.